So can we please have a nice round of applause for the Octopus Gods?
Long ago, when the world was new, a drought dried up the land of the birds. Their plants grew brown and withered away. The birds decided to hold a meeting to send someone in search of rain. Over the trees and mountains, flew the bat, all the way up to the moon.
Off flew the bats until they found the stars at play. But the stars got angry that the bats got in the way of their game.
Get out of here! Away with you!
So sorry, stars. Earth has no rain. Earth has no moon. Earth asks for rain.
Oh, if you want rain, go ask the clouds.
All the bats flew up to the clouds, but they were asleep. Then the bats went to find the wind, and the wind told them.
I can't get up without it together, but the sun has to heat up the earth to bring him up to the sky.
Then the bats flew off to find the sun, and the bats come closer to the sun shouted.
The bats flew down the sunlit path, all the way back to the sun, excited to tell them the news.
So the sun burned down to heat up the earth. The steam goes up to the sky. The wind begins to blow and the clouds are gathered together.
Were soon ready for the harvest.
The birds were happy to see all of the wonderful fruits and nectar the plants that had grown through the trees. They harvested them.
prepared for the celebration. The bats reminded them of their promise.
Don't forget about the egg. The frog is made from the sun.
The birds were not longer in the woods when it climbed over.
The sun went down and the moon and the stars came out, and the celebration began.
All of the birds danced and played their music, the drums were thumping, the food swirled into the night, and the birds danced the night away.
The bats tired and sad fell asleep. Suddenly, they woke up in a panic. The moon and the stars had gone to bed. Slowly, the sun began to peep out.
The bats tried to hide, but as the rays of the sun began to shine down on the trees, the bats were sure that the sun was looking for them. Scared because the promise had not been kept, the bats screamed.
And the bats went flying around the forest looking for a safe place to hide. As the bats flew, they found a cave and flew into it and stayed there.
The bats hid from the shame of not keeping their promise to the sun, a shame that the birds did not feel.
The celebration of the birds continued, but the bats stayed safely in the cave for many days and nights. The bats stayed hidden there and would only come out at night.
Days and months and years went by, but the birds never made the nest. The sun never gave up hope, and every day the sun would take one last look at the forest before slowly sinking away over the horizon.
The sun does this even to this day, hoping that the birds would keep their promise and make the nest. The sun brings up steam so that the winds can blow, then the clouds come together and the rain falls.
The bats made their home in the cave and live there to this day. Whenever the bats hear rain, they wish they could come out and dance to its magical song.
Then the birds and the trees bow quietly to the bats as a thank you to them. Heroes who helped their land become green and beautiful once more.
As I mentioned before, we have read many stories over the course of the year, and the first graders chose which stories they would like to perform for you today. And this was one of the big choices of the entire first grade, but only two got to perform it. So the raccoons are lucky enough to perform it for you today. If you could please give them a round of applause as they go.
The nine Max and Maxine wore their wool suits and made mischief with one kind and another.
Their mother called them,
"You wild things!"
And Max and Maxine said,
"We'll eat you up!"
So they were sent to bed without eating enough. Very night, and Matt and Maxine grew.
A forest grew and grew and grew until the ceiling hung with fog, and the walls became the world all around.
And an ocean tumbled by with a private boat.
For Matt
and Maxine.
And they sailed off through night and day. And in and out of weeks,
and almost over a year,
to where the wild things are.
And when they came to a place where the wild things are, they roared their terrible roar. And gnashed their terrible teeth.
And rolled their terrible eyes.
And showed their terrible claws.
Till Max said,
"Be still!"
And Max tamed them with
the magic trick
of staring into all their yellow eyes without blinking twice.
And they were frightened and called them
the most wild things of all.
And made them king and queen of all the wild things. Then Max and Maxine said,
"Max, the wild from the stars!"
So Max said,
"I give up."
wild things cried.
Oh, please don't go. We'll eat you up. We love you so.
And Maxine said,
no.
The wild things roared their terrible roars. And rolled their terrible eyes.
And showed their terrible claws. And
but Max and Maxine
went into their private boat and waved goodbye.
They sailed back almost over a year.
And in and out of weeks
and
through a
day. And into the night of our own room.
Where they found their supper waiting for them.
And it was still hot.
Let's give them a big round of applause.